NHL has finally said no to the Olympics. No. And here's why. The Olympics are in February, which is where everybody's making a playoff run, and and they're not being compensated. And if their spot players get hurt, teams that are in that playoff run can get hurt. And they believe that it's detrimental to the NHL. They would love to be in the Olympics after the playoffs, but they're not going to be pre-playoffs. They're not going to do it. And Bettman said no. Now, the first person that yapped off was Lundqvist. And Lundqvist took it in social media ass, because a lot of people said, you're washed up, you're finished, shut the fuck up. I like Lundqvist, and I agree with what Lundqvist said, but my rebuttal, and I'm a big fan of Lundqvist, Sir Lundqvist, I agree with the NHL. I don't believe that the NHL teams, the owners, and the players should jeopardize what their mandate is and what they're getting paid for the Olympics. Okay, guys?
You're agreeing with the decision, Frank?
Pardon me?
You're agreeing with Gary Bettman's decision?
Yes.
Wow.
Well, so am I.
Is
so
that
am
right?
I, so we might as well get the cards on the table.
Interesting.
I think that the players don't recognize the fact that they do have to play an extra 2 weeks. And in return for that, 30 of them are rewarded with being Olympians. So if they're so fucking selfish as to suggest they don't get paid, that's bullshit. And then the fact that, as we pointed out, if there's an injury, there's no compensation to the team other than they have a captive insurance. They might get the insurance of his salary. But it doesn't.
But they won't. There's no guarantees.
No, there's no guarantee. And all they want from the Olympics is the same as they got when they went to Sochi. And John, you and I were talking off air. Mm-hmm. It's between 14 and 20 million to cover airfare and to cover disability insurance.
Yeah, and if the NHL can't cover that, then they're, come on.
That's not the point.
John, you're a smart guy. You've been doing sports a long fucking time. Listen to what he's saying, John, before you react, please.
No, they shouldn't have to cover it, John.
Okay.
The IOC are so filthy rich and so conniving that some of their members steal tickets and scalp them.
Yeah. Look at the Irish guy in Brazil. You're absolutely right.
More money than
but
that.
That's what he's saying to you. Yeah. Yeah. Why the fuck should the NHL fork the fucking bill, right?
All right.
For an organization, a monopoly, mm-hmm. that makes one fucking gazillion dollars guaranteed.
All right, well, here's my point. All right, I don't think the $20 million is a lot, but it's a chess game. But here's the thing. The fans want it. The players want it.
No, they don't.
Hockey is losing here.
I think it's inconsequential, and I think,
Frank.
Listen, if the fans wanted it, they should put the Olympic hockey at the back end of the Olympics, not at the front end.
Or the Summer Olympics. Jesus, Murphy. Play like the NBA plays in the Summer Olympics.
If you're playing for your life, for the monetary existence of a franchise, which is what the NHL is, right? It's a business, John.
Yeah.
Fucking business. So, John, I'm going to give you an example, and then you can fucking tell me if I'm full of shit.
Okay.
You own a store, and your number one salesman creates 70% of the revenue for your business, okay? And he decides to go on vacation at the beginning of your prime season where all your business is, right? Are you going to allow him to do that?
Well, they've done it.
John,
since 1998.
Question, yes or no?
Yes.
Are you going to allow him to do that?
Well, they have in
and
the last 20 years.
You hire a fucking ass.
Yes.
And you hire somebody who's going to fucking work the season.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, you shouldn't. You should have the common sense not to do it, but you shouldn't be allowed to leave at prime time, leave your owner holding the bag.
Fucking right, Billy. It's a business, Billy. It's a business. There's small markets hanging on by the fucking hair of their chinny chin chin, if not the skin of their balls, right? It's bullshit that the Olympics, which makes $1 gazillion, and it is a monopoly. I would say the Olympics, there's nothing else that competes with them other than FIFA in World Cup soccer.
Yeah. Okay, let me rebut. Let me have a little rebuttal here. The fans lose here, and the players all want to go. Now, I understand.
The fans, no, you're wrong.
Oh, Bill, can I continue?
You're wrong, John. They did a survey. You're fucking wrong.
No, I'm not.
You can Google it. 46% of the players want to go. The rest don't give a shit.
Yeah, the fact is that only 30 of them go, John. There are 750 of them.
And another, here's the thing. Here's why they pulled the plug. And it's going to be a big problem because the NHL is playing exhibition games in China this fall. If they don't go to South Korea, and that's the problem because there's nothing to gain going to South Korea.
Nobody's going to watch the fucking games in South Korea because of the timeline.
And the owners lost.
That's bullshit.
The owners lost big, and so she.
No, John, you're arguing out of emotion and not fact, John. I believe you're a good guy. I believe you talk from your soul and your heart. But you're talking out of your ass on this one, buddy. Because in Seoul, Korea, what's the time difference, John?
Oh, no, that's if I was going to continue, I would have said that. The owners get nothing from going to Sochi. They got nothing going to Torino because of the time difference. They got nothing to owe to South Korea. South Korea wants them there, but the time difference, that was the key. And the $20 million, it's freaking picking lint off his sweater, for God's sakes. But it's a chess game, and I don't think it's over yet. Maybe we'll bring Bill or Phil Esposito.
I'm telling you right now, rule number one, don't fuck with Gary Bettman.
No, I don't disagree with you, Frankie.
He's a fucking real deal. You don't bullshit Gary Bettman. If I played Gary Bettman in a poker game, I would fucking be very amiss by his bluff. So, Perry, you're a journalist, and you cover sports, and you've written books on a lot of athletes. What's your fucking view on this?
I'll give you my view on it, the World Cup of Hockey. That threw the Olympics right out the window because the World Cup of Hockey makes a lot of money. More NHL players get to be involved in that. The Olympics...
And it's in the summer.
It makes more money. Whether it's in the summer...
But it's in the summer.
That's not the point. Right. You can't play Olympic hockey in the summer. That's ridiculous.
Were you in Toronto for the World Cup of Hockey?
Yeah.
Ask Phil Esposito how much money they made.
Are you saying because it didn't work?
Very much.
No. You're wrong on this one, Billy. They made a huge amount of money. I know from a lot of television deals, it made a lot of money.
Well, that's not as the story goes, and if they did, good
for them. I know for a fact that they gouged the fuck out of people buying tickets. And, you know, Bill, you can, people tell you to fuck off eventually. But they made a lot of money on TV.